Hey guys, it's Mike Chen.
People are different. I think we all know that. Every individual is unique in their own special way. But there is a group of people on this planet, and yes, they are different. They have their own very unique culture and customs. But what really sets them apart is the fact that they can see better, literally see better, than anybody else in the world. The Himba people are an indigenous semi-nomadic people who mostly reside in the Kunene region of northern Namibia. The tribe has an estimated population of around 50,000 and mostly live off livestock farming, particularly breeding sheep and goats. These herders live very simple lives, far different from the modern lifestyles of those who live in urban cities. The tribe is comprised of smaller family communities, and members of these family villages dwell in circular wooden huts, which were built to surround an okuruwu, a sacred fire the Himba people believe allows them to connect with the spirits of their ancestors. And like I mentioned, these people have their own unique traditions and cultures. For one, they are known for covering their skin with red ochre pigment, which is a mixture of clay, sand, and ferric oxide. But another special thing, like I said in the beginning of this video, that really sets them apart from the rest of the world is the way they see and perceive things. You see, even when looking at the same object, people can see things very differently. You know, like beauty is in the eye of the beholder. In the case of the Himba people, this truth applies not only figuratively, but literally as well. And not only do they see things differently from most humans, they seem to do it much, much better. As research shows that they can focus on details better and are also less susceptible to visual distractions. Of course, this interesting finding compels us to ask, well, how is this possible? I mean, if we are all generally born with the same organs needed for seeing and perceiving, shouldn't a traditional community like the Himba people see or perceive our surroundings just like the rest of us? Well, according to scientists, the answer lies in the theory that vision and perception are not solely a matter of biology and neurology. This means that they can also be influenced by external factors such as environment and culture. And in the case of the Himba people, these semi-nomadic people see and perceive the way they do because their minds have really not been altered by, well, Facebook and YouTube and other modernizations, which the likes of Jules Davidoff, a psychologist and professor at Goldsmiths University of London, believes have significantly affected the visual focus and attention of those who belong to more modern urban societies. Davidoff conducted several studies and experiments on vision, perception, and attention with the Himba people as his main subjects, and the results of his research supported the supposition of several other scientists that modernization has indeed changed the way we see, perceive, and pay attention to things we look at. That is why the people belonging to a traditional culture like that of the Himba people are less likely to commit errors in their perception of size and distance and are also less susceptible to getting distracted from their concentration. Many of Davidoff's earlier experiments involving the Himba people utilized the famous Ibn Haz illusion, also known as the Titchener circles. This optical illusion is one that concerns size perception, and it was first developed by renowned German psychologist Hermann Ibn Haz before its use was popularized by British experimental psychologist Edward Titchener. The most famous version of this optical illusion features two circles of the same size placed in proximity of each other in order to be compared by objects looking at them. However, the first circle is surrounded by circles much larger than its size, while the second circle is surrounded by smaller ones. The positions of all the circles involved is supposed to make it appear that the main circle surrounded by the larger circle is smaller than the central circle contained by the small circles. And for most people, the illusion does trick them into thinking that the first central circle is smaller than the latter. However, when Davidoff showed the images to members of the Himba people, they weren't as likely to fall for the same trick. According to an article he published with his colleagues in the Journal of Experimental Psychology in 2007, the illusion had a weak effect on the Himba people because of their bias towards local processing. This meant that when presented with an image featuring multiple objects, they have the tendency to focus on the smaller details, which in case of the Ibn Haz illusion was the main circles instead of the complete picture. And because they ignored the context of what they saw, which has the image of two circles surrounded by large and small circles respectively, the illusion failed to distort their perception. But although the Himba people are biased towards local processing, they actually are more flexible and have more control over their selective attention. This means that while they tend to notice the small details first, they can just as easily see the big picture if they are asked to do so. Further experiments show not only the Himba people's perceptual bias for the small details and their flexible selective attention, but also a reduced distractibility. Compared to people living in cities, Himba people are less affected by visual distractions. They can identify their target objects better than others, even when other moving objects are present to disrupt their focus. A possible explanation for why the Himba people can see and focus better than everyone else is their traditional and simple lifestyle. As herders, part of their everyday life is to identify cattle. To be able to individuate dozens of animals, they had to train their eyes to quickly spot distinct features and markings on their sheep and goats from a distance. And it really comes in handy when they're looking for Waldo. Anyway, those of us who live in urban environments, we live in a really fast-paced and cluttered world where a lot of things tend to all happen at once. We encounter countless buildings and cars and people on a daily basis. Not only that, we usually don't even do one thing at a time. We almost always have to multitask, and because there are so many elements in our surroundings we have to watch out for, it almost becomes necessary for our attention to always be divided. Maybe this also explains some innate, almost supernatural abilities that some say we all used to have, but have lost over the course of time. For example, a lot of Eastern beliefs say that we all have a third eye, that we can see into other dimensions. But as we become more and more ingrained in modern society, innate abilities like those tend to fade out and completely disappear. But let me know what you guys think. Do you feel the modernization in society is actually making us duller, making our senses maybe less sensitive? Let me know your thoughts in the comments below. Thanks so much for watching. See you later.